Good afternoon, race fans. We are here at the legendary place your mama warned you about, Cherokee Speedway in Gaffney, South Carolina, for the inaugural Mike Duvall Memorial event. It's going to be a huge night. Speaking of huge, last night was really big. The streak continues of Brandon Shepherd not picking up the 19th and history-making win. At Livonia Speedway, a three-car battle ensued towards the end between Chris Smokey Madden, Scott Bloomquist, and Brandon Overton. All three drivers sliced and diced over the last 20 laps. When it was all said and done, Chris Madden picked up his second win of the year, 26th on his World of Outlaws career, as he bagged last night's Morton Buildings feature. Scott Bloomquist came home second, Brandon Overton third, and as for Shepherd, still looking for that elusive 19th victory, he came home in the number four spot. Today, we're here at Cherokee Speedway. We're going to be having a great event. It's going to be, as always, World of Outlaws Hot Laps, followed by PFC Breaks Fast Time Qualifying. Last Chance Showdowns, not to count out those Dry Dean Heats, which were phenomenal last night. And the World of Outlaws Morton Buildings feature, 50 laps, 10,000 to win. Brings me great pleasure to bring to the microphone a gentleman I have worked with for a long time. He's president of DMG Marketing. He is the mouth of the South. He is the responsible person for this race, Mr. Duane Goins. Duane, normally I hold the mic in interview. You know how to hold the mic. I'm going to step aside and you can let everybody know how this all came about after you gave me that phone call saying, hey, we want to do something for Brother Mike. Tell everybody how this all worked. What a kind of painstaking task it was for you to get all this organized. And now here we are on race day. Let's talk about that too.
Well, thank you, Rick. It's good to be back. Now, we are standing about where the infield used to be, as this track has 733 feet straightaways back in the day. And where the haulers are parked, that was the turn one and two banking. But I appreciate this opportunity. This is Mike Duvall's house. He is a local regional hero, and he went national. I'm going to say the World 100, 1982. And I got to do a little history here, and I appreciate the time you're going to give me. Pennsboro started in 81, and everybody, what is this? I went there as a fan. I think I got to work with you in 01, yes, you as, you know, 20 years later. But nobody in the South really, this Eldora thing. You know, we had a little newspaper down here, and you'd see the highlights, but that was a world away. And it was a Midwestern kind of a thing and all that. But Mike Duvall went up there and at Flintstone F1yer in 1982 and shook up the world as Jeff Purvis was running him down and broke. But Mike Duvall took that 1982 World 100 win. And really, it told the South that a Southern boy can go up there. And I said, this is a, you know, it put Eldora on the map in the South. And I said, and Duvall, he was a fourth all-time winner on the NDRA circuit behind Buck Simmons and Rodney Combs and Larry Moore. But it brought Mike's hometown on the map, Cherokee Speedway, where he was from, and put Eldora on the map as far as the Southern. And then it took off from there.